Will Dante party his way into Smash? We break down this leak and a lot more Smash Brothers Ultimate. Let's do it! What's happening, my Block buddies, and welcome to a brand new episode of Block Content's Leak Speak. My name is Callum, and this is going to be your content for today. Today, we get to talk all about Dante for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and of course, it's been a long, winding road for this character because a lot of different leaks and speculation actually talk about this character. It feels very fitting for a game like Super Smash Bros. The fighting style of this character really fits well with Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and even if we look at characters like Bayonetta, that, yes, we're going to get into the Bayonetta of it all because that really factors in big, but yes, that fighting style is sort of already represented, and Joker has some stuff of that as well with the gunplay. I think there's a lot possible with Dante. It's not a lot of people's like favorite go-to third-party character because there's of course these big mascot fighters like Rayman, Crash Bandicoot, stuff like that. But I mean, if you are looking to third-party characters, especially more characters from Capcom, I really think that a character like Dante would make sense. And of course, there's a lot of fun that you can actually do with the announcement trailer for this character, and that's actually where we're going to focus our efforts for today's video, because this actually details the entirety of a supposed, you know, release or announced trailer for that character. Now, we know nothing about an upcoming Nintendo Direct right now. Yesterday, we just had the Nintendo Direct Mini. As I'm recording this, actually, the brand new, like, Gamescom live footage is happening, so maybe there's information about that. If something happens there, of course, I will talk about it. But mainly, this is about Dante and Dante's journey to Super Smash Bros. There's also an article that talks a little bit more about extra evidence for Dante coming to Smash Bros. Ultimate. And of course, we've already had some rumblings in the past as well with the voice actor V actually, you know, spilling the beans on like, yeah, and of course Dante's in Smash Bros. I mean, this situation is ever developing and ever more interesting. So I really wanted to take the time to talk about that with you guys today. And of course, I've also been answering many of you guys' questions about Smash Ultimate and new fighters in our show Question Blocked, where I answer your questions. What do I think of your favorite game? How do you start making YouTube content? Well, whatever you can think of, send your question through to blockedcontentmail@gmail.com, and I will answer your question live on the show in our next Question Blocked episode. And of course, we're starting a brand new Blocked Content show, and with everything going on in the world right now, it's a little bit difficult to get something off the ground that has two people working together, two strangers, but we're in the works. If you want us to play a specific game that you love, put it down in the comments right now and we will take it into account. All right, guys, let's talk about this leak of today. I'll just break it down first and foremost, and then we get to talk about all the details. I'll try and do it as cinematic as possible because I think that that's the way that this was written. Of course, there's no way to find out if this is real or fake. Right now, let's take it as speculation and let's just talk about it, right? The time is 8:47 p.m., dark, and it's about to rain. Bayonetta is walking in a city, looking for a place, obviously unbothered. She poses with a Smash letter, looks up at this neon illuminating sign. It says, Devil May Cry. Hours of operation, 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. She enters and is disgusted by the unkempt building's condition. Trish then says, Devil May Cry, sounding unmotivated and slightly annoyed. Bayonetta says, My, what a pretty face. Are you the person who they call the Devil Hunter? Cheeky and belittling. Trish then says, No, that would be Dante. He's out doing business. Bayonetta says, Oh, the Devil Hunter himself is busy. I'm such a fool for thinking that this Dante knew how to take care of demons. Too much to handle. Knows full well that she knows something that Trish isn't telling her. A sudden loud burst is coming from the side of the building. Bayonetta turns to the sound and is unamused. Then, of course, which times a rocket coming directly at her and an explosion happens. Half of the Devil May Cry building is destroyed. Lady, she said Dante was busy, ma'am. Bayo, oh, it seems that I forgot to ask. And what might your name be, young lady? Lady. Ugh, why did they send me to deal with these uncooperative people? I don't think we're the uncooperative ones here, ma'am. By your logic, you seem to have barged into a business that obviously is not open for business, like, you know, closed. So why don't you just leave? I beg your pardon? Is that any way you should speak to a customer? Looks like I will have a chat with your manager about this unprofessional. The door is kicked wide open. A silhouette of a man carrying something massive on his back. An obvious trench coat that's crimson red illuminates the room. A lightning bolt is heard off in the distance. The lightning illuminates this dark figure. It's Dante, with 8 boxes of pizzas. Dante says, "All right, ladies, who's ready to party?" Dante starts the party. Well, that is the entirety of that trailer breakdown. I tried to do it a little bit more cinematic than I usually do. I hope you guys like that. So what I think of this, I think there's a lot of dialogue. I do think that we got that World of Light kind of intro, the initial teaser, of course, that had a couple of characters actually talking in it, and I thought it was really cool. You know, Fox was talking in that thing. We had Pitt. We even had Zelda. I mean, that's super cool. Marth was in there as well. So the idea of having voice acting in an intro or in some sort of trailer isn't outside of the realm of possibility, but it's never really happened in something like a newcomer trailer, right? I mean, some small things like Ken saying, you know, fight fire with fire, huh? Let's do it, you know? But nothing as big as that. So really curious if they will actually do something that feels like this. But I do feel like two characters kind of live in that same universe, and it would totally make sense for them to actually have a dialogue with each other, because of course those games are actually, unlike Smash Brothers, very full of dialogue. So I was super curious about that. Now, Dexerto.com also posts something about this character, about Dante, and potentially coming to Smash Ultimate. So let's read about it over here. Originally posted by Michael Williams saying, "New Smash Ultimate clues hint at Dante being Fighter Pass Volume 2 DLC. Evidence is stacking up in favor of Devil May Cry's Dante coming to Super Smash Bros. Ultimate as a future DLC fighter. Capcom's gun and sword wielding bad boy has been a popular candidate to make it to Smash for a while, but lately there have been some clues that this may point to his arrival in Nintendo's flagship fighter. The most recent theory comes from when Platinum Games co-founder and former Devil May Cry director Hideki Kamiya was asked about which characters he wants to see in Smash Ultimate during a Game Explain interview. Kamiya stated that he would like to see Leonhart Leo Victorion from The Anarchy Reigns, Wonder Red from Wonderful 101, Beautiful Joe, and Okami's Amitsuru in the game, but neglected to mention Dante. This exclusion is key because back in December 2018, Kamiya posted a poll on his Twitter asking fans which character they would like to see in Smash. The options available were Dante, Beautiful Joe, Amaterasu, and Wonder Red. While the poll has since been deleted, Dante reportedly led the pack with a whopping 40% of the vote. This is significant because, according to writer Liam Robertson, Kamiya has used Twitter polls to survey for future projects as well. Could Kamiya have purposely left Dante out when questioned by Game Explain because of the Son of Sparta is already a lock for Fighters Pass Volume 2? Well, Liam Robinson posts, "Hideki Kamiya has put up a poll asking fans which of his characters they'd like to see in Smash. This might seem insignificant, but let me tell you that Kamiya genuinely does these Twitter things to survey for future projects and collabs. It may well actually mean something. A while back, he put up a poll asking which Capcom game they'd like to see him work on. In my research, I found that he was actually in talks with Capcom at the time to make that happen. It was his way of tallying the interest. The M theory and DMC. Additionally, another new theory that possibly points towards Dante is M theory. Basically, according to M theory, Nintendo purposely presents showing logos from M-rated games in promotional content, including Sakurai Presents videos, to keep the ESRB compilation rating at everyone to teen. Notably, for Mii Fighters, the North American versions of the trailers remove references to Assassin's Creed and Fallout, replacing the names with Altair and Vault Boy. Meanwhile, the European trailers keep the Assassin's Creed and Fallout logos. Plus, on the Fighters Pass Volume 2 screens, the ARMS logo isn't shown in the North American version, while it is in all the others. Well, it's possible that an upcoming fighter is from an M-rated game, such as Devil May Cry, and Nintendo doesn't want to show the DMC logo on the Fighters Pass Volume 2 page, because it would result in an E to M rating. slip of the tongue. Moving on, these voice actor that we also mentioned in Devil May Cry 5 seem to inadvertently reveal that Dante would be coming to Smash when discussing the game. To be part of Marvel vs. Capcom or Super Smash Bros. Would be huge, which is what Dante is going to be. Brian Hanford blurted out after gushing over the fighting game franchise in an interview. It's possible that Hanford had loose lips when discussing Smash and revealed more than he was technically allowed to. And finally, in 2019, Devil May Cry director Hideaki Itsuno hinted that in order to be in Smash, a franchise needs to have some history with Nintendo. Well, you think about it, I'm pretty sure that they, all the characters in Smash, at least have some game on a Nintendo platform, right? He said in an interview with VG247. Well, that's the thing, Devil May Cry has never been on a Nintendo platform, so it seems like the first thing to do would be to get Capcom to put Devil May Cry on a Nintendo platform in some way, shape, or form, whatever game that might be. Since then, Devil May Cry has come out on the Nintendo Switch, seemingly meeting all the criteria Itsuno laid out for the fighter to be eligible. While there's still no guarantee he'll be coming, with all this circumstantial evidence, it's looking more and more likely that Dante ends up arriving in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's Fighters Pass Volume 2. Now, of course, all this information, totally crazy, too much to talk about. I'm really curious if you guys have any specific thoughts on Dante potentially coming to Smash Bros. Ultimate. I think it is stacking up, and somewhere within that pass, it would make total sense to have that character, kind of like a Joker spot or something like that, and the other characters being, you know, bigger third-party characters, maybe another first-party characters. I would love to hear what you guys think of this. If you comment down below, that could actually be featured and read out loud in our next video. And today's comment question is, well, do you think Dante is actually coming to Smash? Is this description real? And as for our previous comment question winner, our answer comes to us from Ivantendo BR, saying, it just don't make sense at all to do Spirit Board events with characters that are not from the Origami King if Paper Mario comes to Smash. If they wanted to add Paper Mario, they should have been waiting to add the spirits later. Paper Mario is deconfirmed for sure, and I'm glad because Paper Mario is not the face of the Mario RPGs anymore, so ultimately it would be a third Mario that people will compare with the three Links in the game. Now, I would say that Dr. Mario is more iconic than Paper Mario because at least he is from a well-established puzzle game and not from a series that was an RPG and changed into an adventure or puzzle game. Paper Mario does not deserve to be in Smash pronto. Well, Ivantendo, I am going to heavily disagree with you on this one. I think there's a lot of bias in your comment, but I do really feel like I know where you're coming from. You know, the franchise has, of course, changed dramatically over the years, but I definitely think that, especially with Nintendo, Paper Mario is a lot more lucrative than something like Dr. Mario or other, you know, spin-off series, and I think it would make a lot of sense for Paper Mario to actually arrive in Smash Bros. He is not necessarily the face of Mario, but he is an offshoot of Mario that is one of the most popular ever, right? I mean, think about the March of the Minis stuff, or, you know, a classic, you know, sprite-based Mario, and then you think of Paper Mario if you think about all the different versions. So, I gotta disagree with you there. I think that there's a lot of leeway here for actually Paper Mario to end up in Smash. Thank you guys so much for sending in all your comments. These are always so much fun to read through. And of course, a big shout out to our latest Patreon supporters. It means the entire world to me that you guys would support this channel in a time this crazy in the world. So if you want to support this channel and even get your own content actually made, please go to patreon.com/blockedcontent. There's a bunch of incredible rewards there and they're waiting for you. And remember, if you're not yet a member of the Blocked Content family yet, hit subscribe now, smash that like button, and ring the bell for notifications, and all the news and fun you care about will be delivered on the daily to you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you around the corner where there's always more Blocked Content. See ya!